Opening balances. In this video, I'm going to take you through how we set our opening balances for our cash and for our banks. So let's get started. We need to be in our subledger account. So let's click on our subledger module. And then on the toolbar, let's click on all. First of all, I just want to see if we have any opening balance accounts. So let's type in opening in our search field and hit enter. And you'll see that we don't have anything. So now we need to actually create that. So we go up to our toolbar and we click on new. We need to put in the account name, so we're going to call it opening balance. And now we need to pick the main account that comes from. So this is going to come from our opening ledger account. So we can either type in opening or we can double click right here. And it will be in our account currency, so that's US dollars. So now we can just click on save down in the bottom. And you'll see that we now have an opening balance account. So clicking on the invoice module icon, we need to go to the toolbar and click on new. And for this invoice, it's going to be a self transaction. So we can either type in self in the custom field, or when we click on the adjustments button, this actually, the system knows that it's a self transaction, so it will automatically fill that in. So we click on adjustments. But before we do that, we need to set the date. So the system will generate this invoice as today's date. If today is your opening for your business, it is recommended that we actually put in the date before today, so yesterday's date, so that we can keep our opening balance separate from any transactions that we do today. And I can show you what that looks like once we've entered that in here. And now we can come down to our adjustments button. So let's click right here. And we want to work with our cash, so let's click on the cash till button. And for this example, we're going to be putting the opening balance into our main till. So we're going to use 00 for that and click on OK. And now we can manually enter in the amounts that we have for our opening balance. So let's say that we have 40,000 US and we have 8,000 Australia dollars. Now the system will automatically get the rate from today's rate. Now, obviously, the amounts that we have, so Australian dollars and so on, were bought on a different day. So that being said, we can now actually change the rate because the rate probably wasn't the same when we bought these. And we want to really reflect the true value of those Australian dollars in our currency for our opening balance. So we can do that right here. So instead of the 0.9398, maybe it was 95 that we bought it at. And we can tab down and enter in other currencies and do the same for those as well. Maybe this one was at this rate instead. And so on and so forth. Just putting in a few for this example and changing the rates as they most likely weren't the same as what today's rate is. And once we've done that, we can now come down to the bottom and apply our adjustments. You'll see on the invoice, the line items is everything we've just received. And then we also have down below the value in our local currency. So that's how much it's equivalent to. So now we need to put this into an account, pay this into an account. So up into this field, we need to now put paid. So let's just clear this for this example and type in paid. And we need to pay that into an account. So selecting account. And then we go down to add row. So when we add the row, we now need to select an account. So as we created the opening balance just previously to this invoice, we can now select our opening balance by double clicking, or we can select and click on pick account. And then we can save. So you see that the invoice now balances out, and you can see the line items that we have right here, and that we've actually paid it into our opening balance. So now we can click on save, and I want to go back into our subledger account. So going back in, we can select all and then click on the today button. You'll now see that we have the amounts that we just put in underneath our opening column, and then we have it paid into our opening balance. Now the significance of the date being yesterday's date now means that any transactions we do today, you will see under these columns here, you're bought and you're sold. So now we can keep our opening balance separate from any of those transactions. So now we've done our cash, Let's do the same for our bank accounts. So going back into our invoice module, we need to create a new invoice. So clicking on new on your toolbar, and again, it's a self-transaction, and we want to change the date as well. Let's do that again to the day before, so we can keep these transactions separate from anything that we do today. And then we click on adjustments, and this time we click on banks only. So now we can do the exact same thing we did before, and enter in the amounts that we want to put into our banks to start our opening balance, so our opening business. So let's put that in right here. And again, it's going to be at the rate that you actually bought the currency at. So that might be different from today's rate, so we can change that here. Okay, and then we can apply those adjustments as well. So once we've done that, let's click on clear, and let's pay that into the account again. So we click on account, and then add row, and we pick the opening balance again. So we can double click or click and then pick account and save. So now we have zeroed out this transaction as well, and we can click on save again. Now going back into our subledger account, let's click on all and then today, and you'll see we now have our banks. We have the opening balances for all of our three banks, and now we have the bought and sold columns free for any transactions we do within those banks today, so we can keep those separate. So this is how you do your opening balances for your cash and your bank accounts.